Well, students, today I will explain about number system. Okay, so what is number system? What sub part is there in the number system? While we were in class 5-6, we used to learn about even number, composite number, odd number, co-prime number. Okay, all about that. After that, we are going to learn about various different types of rational number from class 7 onwards. Okay. So first is our integers. In class 7 we have integers. Okay. Now after that we have to study about our rational numbers. After that we will learn about real number. In real number there is two types of variables we have to study, about the rational number just I have written and another is irrational number. So before starting the chapter, I would like to explain about the basic things from beginning. What is integers? Okay, so to know about integers, I'm going to explain through a number line. Okay, this is a number line. Okay, what is integers? See, this is zero. Right hand side we have all positive number 1, 2, 3, 4. Left hand side we have all negative numbers, isn't it? Okay. So this represent the integers. Okay. Now how we will define it? See, this all is positive number. This one is zero. On this side we have all negative numbers. Okay. To define integers, this is the first topic chapter of class 7 integers. Okay. So from this number line, how we will define integers? Okay. Integers can be defined as, see, with the help of this number system, a set of all positive and negative numbers including zero is called integers. Okay, so all positive and negative numbers including zero is called integers. Simple definitions. Okay, so a set of all positive negative numbers including zero. Please set this definition into mind. Including zero is called integers. Okay, is called integers. Okay, clear? Now we will go to next. If you want to write example, these are the example. Example as minus 1, 12, minus 15, 0, all these are examples of integers. Okay. Now we will come to know what is rational number. Okay. Before that, I would like to explain about fraction. Okay. What is fraction? Okay. Generally, we say that fraction is a number which is expressible in the form of P by Q or A by V generally. Okay. So, a fraction, normally we define a combination of numerator and denominator. Okay, that is, we write a fraction as this way, numerator by denominator, that is in the form of P by Q or A by V. Okay, so combination of numerator and denominator is called a fraction, or a number which can be expressed in the form of A by B is called fraction. Okay, now fraction is clear, integer is clear. So now it will be better to know about rational number. I would like to come to know that how you understand integers and fraction. Yes, let's proceed for rational number. So before explaining the rational number, I would like to write the definition. After that I will explain the rational number. So let's see, a number in the form of P by Q. A number in the form of P by Q. Okay. If I write a number in the form of P by Q, that means it is a fraction. This is the definition of a fraction. A number in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers. This is the main reason why I have explained you integers and fraction before writing the definition of rational number. So a number in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers, but is not equal to 0. Q is not equal to 0. Okay. So, Q is not equal to 0 means in denominator, there should not be any 0. Denominator should not contain any 0. It should not contain any 0. Okay. So, P and Q can be positive or negative. P and Q can be positive or negative. But do remember that in denominator, Q should not be 0. For example, if I write here, 2 by 3, it's a rational number, minus 7 by, and it's a rational number, 0 by 1, it is a rational number, but 2 by 0 is not a rational number. Is that clear? Now, from a part of irrational number, we have various types of forms in decimal. When a rational number is expressed, when a fraction is expressed in the form of decimal.